So now what we're going to do is we're going to pretend we're actually working with a full band right now. We've set our input gain, we've got our monitor levels, we've got everything coming through the system, and now we're going to work on EQ, compression, and effects. Now the effects aren't actually going to be interactive on this, so we're just going to pretend that they're there and working. The EQ and the compression you will actually be able to hear. So I'm going to play back a recording of last week's worship rehearsal, and you'll be able to see how we actually do a mix on this. So the first thing I'm going to start working on is the kick drum. So if I select kick, the quickest and easiest thing for you to do if you don't have a lot of experience with mixing is to load a preset. So let's load, go to channel, load, scroll over here under the master control until we get to kick. Now hit recall, and there we go. We've got a full kick drum setting. So we'll drop these others. Here's how it sounded before. Here's how it sounds with some EQ and compression. Just a little bit tighter, a little bit crisper. We'll turn on that gate and it'll get rid of any outside noise. This will be a great just first startup if you want to start working with your kick drum. So now let's go over to snare drum. Hit select on that, load, scroll over to snare drum. I'm gonna go with DRM fat snare. Hit recall, and there we go. We have a full snare setup. Raise that snare up. Okay, now let's work on our overheads. Hit select on the overheads. I'm actually gonna pan these hard left and hard right, and then when I click back on 5, I'm gonna hit link. What this is gonna do is it's gonna make a stereo link between the two, and since our overheads are in stereo, it's a perfect setup. So now, I've got overhead selected, got load, and I'm gonna scroll over and I'm gonna go with preset 14, overhead rock. Hit recall on that, and now we have a decent setting for our overheads. This is gonna be mostly our cymbals, but as well as just a full rounded kit sound. Now I'll go over to electric guitar here. I hit load, it's already set on load. I'm gonna scroll over until I hit guitar rock. I'm gonna hit that. You hear how that makes it a little bit crisper, a little bit tighter sounding. It's dropped out some of the lows. You can see over here, it's already set a high pass filter at about 100 hertz, which is gonna get rid of any of that low end boominess that really isn't necessary in the electric guitar, seeing as how we have the bass guitar to carry that sound. All right. So that totally sets up my EQ and my compression to a pretty good guess on what's gonna work well for this guitar setting. Now if I could still take this and I customize it any way I want. I'll turn off load channel, select, and then let's compress it a little bit more. All right, because it wasn't really getting that much compression. I'm gonna turn up the ratio to about 4, maybe 5 to 1. Compress it a little bit harder. You can see this red meter right here, that GR stands for gain reduction, and this is telling us how much it's actually reducing as it comes in. So the ratio here, I'll change it to 3 to 1 for simple math. What that means is for every 3 decibels coming in, 1 decibel is allowed out, and you can see the gain reduction actually happening there. So if I were to slam the threshold all the way on, it's gonna disappear completely. Obviously, I don't wanna do that. I'm gonna dial it back to the point that it sounds natural, but that it's still compressing the guitar and keeping it at a more constant level. Next up, let's work with our bass. We're gonna do the same easy way of just preloading a preset. Select bass, turn it up here. We'll start our song back from somewhere where it has bass. All right, you can hear that bass rocking there. Select, I'll press load. Now scroll over in the master control until we hit bass. Oop, backwards. I'm gonna go with bass electric 2. Press recall. And you can hear what it's done to that bass. It's like we've dropped some of the low mids a little bit. We've compressed it just a little bit, not a whole lot. It's got an auto compressor on it. It's gonna be a really nice light compressor. An easy setting to start with when you're just loading up presets. So now we turn load off and we're back to normal. We can mix however we want. Finally, let's get into the vocals. So I'm gonna hit vocals. Vox 1, I know, is the female singer. I'm gonna go to load, scroll over until I get to vocals. Preset 46 is Vox Female 1. Hit recall, and there we go. We've got a rough setting to start with for the female vocals. I'll do the same thing again with the male vocals on channel 21. Hit select on channel 21, load, scroll over till we get male, hit recall. It's set everything up there. Raise up my vocal channel here. And you'll hear when the male vocals come in that we've got a little bit of compression going on, some EQ, it's brought out the highs a little bit, it's dropped, or it's raised some of the highs. Hasn't really worked anything with the lows. What I'll probably end up doing is cutting some low mids, maybe even some low lows. I'll turn off load here, and then I can manipulate it from there. Right. If I want to do my own compression setting, I'm going to set it a little higher, turn up that threshold, do a real quick attack. It's got a pretty decent release, but I'll set it to about 12 milliseconds. Your makeup gain here is just if it's compressing it so much that you're losing volume, you just simply turn up that makeup gain. And you can see it starts changing that there. Now finally, if we wanted to work with effects, we would go over to channels, let me restart this, go over to these final auxes, effects A and effects B. First off, let's turn up our master outputs, because otherwise we're not going to get anything. Then we hit mix, and you, just like your monitors, you decide how much you're going to blend in. So on the vocals, I'm going to blend that lead in like that. Over here we've got our effects bus, so we'll raise that up, and that's like a master fader that we could just quickly throw down, like if the vocalist is going to start talking or reading scripture or anything in between. We obviously don't want a bunch of reverb on her voice while she's doing that, so we'll have it up during her singing, and then we can just drop it down, or we can even just hit the mute button and it's done real quick. Same thing for delay. We've got delays here. Blend in a little bit of delay on both of them. One awesome thing about delay on the Presonus is you can tap tempo. So I'm just tapping along with the song right now. And if we could actually hear the effects, which we can't when it's hooked up via FireWire like this, you'd actually be able to hear the delay is repeating in the same tempo that we're playing the song at. It creates a really cool effect, really helps the effects to blend into the song well. So again, just hit mix, dial it in on the channel that you want to work with, and you're good to go. To get out of it, press select, and you're back to your normal setup there. So now let's just kind of turn everything up and see how it sounds. It's important to walk around the room, really utilize the full space of what you're working with and not just your mix position, because different areas of the room are going to sound different. So we're going to turn it up, we'll walk around the room, we'll go back, make some more adjustments, and do whatever you need to do to create a sound that is tight, that isn't super heavy in any particular frequencies, and then always be manning the faders. Treat the soundboard like an instrument. You're never just going to sit back and relax when a band is playing. You're actually going to play the soundboard and be raising up levels and dropping down levels, you know, with the parts of the song that really fits. So let's bring this back a little bit. Actually, we'll just take it to the beginning and watch as I just bring up and bring down levels within that. We got our kick drum going right off the bat. There's a loop. Fade that loop in. I'm gonna drop it down a little bit. The loop is really just there to kind of fill up some space. It would be the same thing as if we had some keys or pads going on. You don't want them coming out in front of everything unless that part calls for it. So that loop I'm going to keep really far back in the mix unless it really needs to shine in a particular part. So I'm just listening to everything. I'm kind of comparing. Is anything too loud? Is anything too quiet? Are we missing different instruments? Are they getting lost in the mix? You hear that loop coming through right now? It's sitting really nicely. All right, so I'm hearing the bass is just way too hot. It's riding on the top of the mix. So I'm just gonna drop the fader on that a little bit. I'm gonna raise the overheads just a little bit. You probably wouldn't need to do this in our live setting because we'll actually have live drums. So I've hit input again just to see, is anything too loud? Is anything clipping? Right now everything looks perfect. At this point, a musician might be pointing at their instrument and pointing upwards or downwards, saying, hey, I want this turned up or down. So you can do that on the fly mixing and nobody will hear that. You just go and turn up whatever you want turned up, all right? Right now, we don't have anything dialed into these. Now, don't make sure, unless absolutely necessary, only in case of like an emergency, it's clipping or getting a ton of feedback, don't adjust the input gain after you've set that. Because what will happen is, because that's the sprinkler spigot, if you drop that down or raise that up, it's going to affect everything else, and that's going to screw up the monitor mixes for the musicians. They're going to be really upset, as well as it's going to totally change your house sound. So when adjusting levels, make sure you're just working with the things that you actually want to adjust. So for the mains, working with our channel faders. For the monitor mixes, going to the individual monitors and dialing in or out what we want more or less of. So that probably does it here for how to set up EQ and compression and a rough mix. Let's move on to this next section.